Hey, hello and good morning everyone. The last day of the week and the last story for this week. It has been quite challenging for me to do a story every single day. So, let's get rolling. This story is How Another Student Learned to Laugh at Abuse, Wisdom. Okay, the former story was from ancient India. The following story is from ancient Greece, where the method of education was very similar. A single teacher would teach his students everything. This was the story I read yesterday, actually. So please watch that video, but I continue. I was so experienced after 2 years at Fulbourn Hospital that on Thursday the head of the OT department assigned me to one group all by myself for the first time. First part of the afternoon and another group for the second part of the afternoon, again by myself. I never suspected a thing. Those Down syndrome friends sure could keep a secret. As I was about to leave, the real OT staff, the ones who were paid, called me into the big room. There stood all my Down syndrome friends, grinning like their face would split. Together with the staff, they were to make a presentation to me as the longest volunteering student that they had ever had. While I had been working with one group, the other group and the staff were busy making presents for me. Now they were to make the presentation. The gifts were not refined to sell in any shop, but they made cry. By now I had learned from my Down syndrome teachers how to let the tears flow in public. It was delightful. The head of the OT department said she had realized that my final examination were to begin next week and that this would be my last day, hence the wonderful ceremony of gratitude. I replied through my tears that actually my exams did not for another 10 days. May I come back next week, please? They kindly allowed me an extra week. Looking back, I learned most of what is now called emotional intelligence from those Down syndrome friends. To this day, I regard them as the experts, my teachers. Okay, this was a bit weird. I actually read the wrong story, but just published this. So, bye-bye.